This is an example problem showing how to calculate the magnetic field due to three parallel wires, all of which have the same current. Okay, so we have three parallel wires here, here, and here. All of them are carrying a current of 3 amps, and they're separated, each of them are separated by a distance of 2A, where A is 2 centimeters. So we have a distance A from here to here, a distance A from here to here, and then a distance of A from here to here and here to here, so that the distance between this point and this wire right here is 2A. Okay, and we're going to find the magnetic field due to all three of these wires at this point P right there. Okay, now to do that, what we need to do is find the magnetic field due to wire 1 plus the magnetic field due to wire 2 plus the magnetic field due to wire 3. But because magnetic field is a vector, we must add those three magnetic fields as vectors in order to find the total magnetic field at point P. Okay, so that means that we have to worry about not just the magnitude of the magnetic field, but we also have to worry about the direction. Now, the magnitude of the magnetic field is due to a long straight wire is given by this equation here, B equals mu 0 I over 2 pi R, where R is the distance from the wire to the point in question. But before we can add, so what we can do is find that the magnetic field due to one of these wires, using that equation, is mu 0, which is 4 pi times 10 to the minus 7, times I, which is 3 amps, all over 2 pi. Over the distance between the wire in question and the point in question. So for this wire right here, that distance would be 2A. So I will multiply this by 2A. And A is 2 centimeters, which is 0.02. meters. You have to be careful to use the SI unit for length, so you need to convert centimeters to meters. We already have the current in amps, which is the SI unit for current. Now, that would give us the magnetic field due to that wire right there, but in order to find the total magnetic field at point P, we need to find the direction of the magnetic field due to all three of these wires to see, you know, if we should add them, subtract them, or perhaps we'll have to resolve them into components and add them using trigonometry. So let's take the first wire, this one, and I'm going to redraw that wire. The dot indicates that the current is coming out of the screen toward you. Okay, so how am I going to figure out the direction of the magnetic field of that wire down here at point P? Well, I'm going to use the right-hand rule. So what you should do is, using your right hand, you should point your thumb in the direction that the current is flowing. So point your thumb using your right hand in the direction that the current is flowing, which is out of the screen toward you, the viewer. Okay, and when you do that, if you curl the fingers in your right hand, those fingers will be curling in the direction of the magnetic field. So your fingers will be curling counterclockwise this. Okay, so that means that the magnetic field due to that wire at point P is to the right, because if I take that point right there, point P, then at that point, the magnetic field is tangent to the circle, and it's that way. Okay, now let's figure out what's the magnetic field going to be due to the second wire, that one. So, do the same thing. Okay, point your thumb of your right hand out of the screen toward you, the viewer, and your fingers will curl in the direction of the magnetic field, again making a circle. Okay, and again going counterclockwise. But we see that this time, counterclockwise means that way, to the left. Now, because all of the numbers in this equation up here are the same for both of those wires, both of them have a current of 3 amps, and both of them have a distance from the point in question of 2 centimeters, then the magnitude of those two fields are the same, but as we've just seen, their directions are opposite. So that means if this is wire 1 and this is wire 2, then the magnetic field due to wire 1 and the magnetic field due to wire 2 are going to cancel each other out, so I don't even have to calculate what they are. That means that the total magnetic field at point P is simply going to be the magnetic field due to wire number 3. Its magnitude is given by this equation right here, because the current is 3 amps, the distance from wire number 3 to point P is 1A plus another 1A, that's 2A right here. So if you plug those numbers into your calculator, you get that the magnitude of the magnetic field at point P is given by 1.5 times 10 to the minus 5 Tesla. Now, in order to complete the problem, we need to tell the direction, because magnetic field is a direction. So if you give only the magnitude, you've only given half the answer. We need a direction. So finally, let's figure out what is the direction of the magnetic field at point P due to wire number 3. So once again, point the thumb of your right hand out of the screen toward you, the viewer. Your fingers will curl in the direction of the magnetic field, and they'll make a big circle like this, okay, which again curls in the clockwise counterclockwise direction. So that right here at point P, the magnetic field will be directed tangent to this circle, which is straight down. So the answer is that the total magnetic field at point P due to those 3 wires is 1.5 times 10 to the minus 5 Tesla directed down.